Sorry, Leslie Grossman and I.
We have things to talk about.
We haven't seen each other since the last Chabad telethon.
That is
and here we are. All right, here's the thing that is a good lesson. A, you're a talented actress.
Thank you.
Popular that Ryan Murphy put together many, many years ago.
Yes.
You guys became pals there.
Yeah.
And what's nice is Ryan Murphy hasn't forgotten about you.
Well, yes, thank goodness he has not forgotten about me. Yeah, it's really fun that we get to work together again.
Does Colt scare you?
Yes. It's terrifying. It's really, really scary. When I first read the scripts, I thought, well, I can't do this. This is not something I could possibly ever accomplish or pull off. But, you know, I have to say this. I have a lot of friends and family that have said, I can't watch it. I'm so sorry. I'm terrified.
Yeah.
And what I say is this. Yes. Is it scary? Mm-hmm. Is it gory? Of course. But it's a real psychological thriller as well. And there's a lot of super fun puzzle pieces to put together. And I think that's a really interesting, fun part of the show. You will not know until the very last frame of the show.
Okay, but you know Ryan Murphy.
Yes.
How does he come up with all these crazy, scary concepts?
Because he's a wild genius, that's why. I mean, he really is a true genius. And he comes in at the beginning of the writing and he says, these are my thoughts. These are my incredible ideas. And the writers go and make them happen.
But is he floating in midair when he says that?
It's incredible. Yes, well, somebody, he has.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. Somebody's following behind him.
And then, is Repertory Company the best way to put it? How many of you continue from American Horror Story?
I don't know the numbers,
right.
Sam.
Okay.
But there's a lot of us. And I love that he, you know, the thing about Ryan that's so incredible is he believes that you can do something before you can believe that you can do it yourself, which is great. Yeah. And he gives people incredible opportunities. And he's also a huge fan of people playing against type, which is really lucky. This is not something I ever thought I'd be involved in. I'm in the comedy world. I do the comedy stuff. I love a sitcom.
Right.
So this is not a world that I really saw myself being a part of. And at first I was like, oh no, you're making a terrible mistake, Ryan. But you end up pulling it off and you feel amazing about yourself. And he's like, I always knew you could do it.
Oh, that's great.
So, but he does use the same actors over and over again, which I love.
And what I was thinking about, are your relationships as actors different in each incarnation? Do you know what I mean? In other words, like, she's a good guy this time, she's an evil one this time. Do you treat
like are our relationships between each other different?
Right, yes.
No.
No, okay.
I was the same. And I do have to say,
right,
yes, the show is very dark and moody and scary. It's probably the most fun I've ever had on any job that I've ever done. Everyone is brilliant, hilarious, funny, and the crew is incredible, and we have a very, very good time. Also, some of the stuff you're doing is so ridiculous and over the top that you just laugh.
Well, we have a little snarky clip here, I think it's fair to say, where you meet the new neighbors.
Yeah.
Watch.
Okay.
I'm Ivy Mayfair Richards, and this is my very worried wife, Allie.
Oh, thank God. I always say the best way to bring up property values is to have some lesbians move in. Responsible homeowners, usually one of you is handy. I'm guessing that would be you.
That is a great little scene.
And who is the beekeeper?
Billy Eichner.
And is he your...
He plays my
husband
on the show.
Okay.
And he is... First of all, people can be very surprised by Billy in
the show. Well, because talk about a guy who has a very identifiable type.
Billy is an excellent actor, and he, exactly, and talk about playing against type, and we had the best time together, and I love him so much. I think I love him too much. It makes him a little bit uncomfortable. I like to force affection on
him. Right. You know, it happens on occasion. And you just said this. You literally just finished.
Yeah. I finished, I think, at like 5 a.m. on Friday.
Wow.
It was my last day, and I'm sad. I'm adrift emotionally now that it's over, Sam. But it really was such a good time. And it's so corny to say, but it was like a family. It's like summer camp.
And then has he announced the next one? Is your thought that there will be a next one, or what do you think?
Oh, I think there already, I think there's a season 8 and 9, I think.
Wow.
I mean, I hope I'm correct. Don't quote me on that. But there's definitely another season, which I know nothing about. Let's get through this one, Sam.
Do that. All right. We're doing a Rosh Hashanah segment later, but you can stay for it if you want.
I really should.
Okay.
We'd love to have you. I'm very excited about Rosh. It's one of my favorite holidays, Sam. Are you excited?
Well, here's the thing. Both of our kids go to religiously oriented schools.
Yes.
Does your daughter now know more about obscure Jewish holidays than you've ever heard of?
Yes, and gets mad at me and yells at me when I don't know what I'm talking
about. It's like, Mom, it's Shavuos.
Yes.
I'm like, what is Shavuos?
Exactly. I don't know. And I feel like they're making up holidays now.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, why do you have school off today? She's like, you know, it's when Moses thought about the commandments. I'm like, okay. Didn't know about that
one. It is the craziest thing. Leslie, really good to see you.
Good to see you.
Yeah, thanks.
American Horror Story Cult, Tuesdays at 10.
Okay.
FX. We'll tune in.